Hall Studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
It is an elite day to be back on the air. A little bit bittersweet to also be back on the air, but it's not the final time that we will be on the air. This is Kyle Brustin Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. I'm Ben Brust alongside fraudulent Marquette fan, Kyle Wallace.
What do you mean? I'm a new fan today. I got a new team.
Of course you do.
I decided I need to go back to my roots. So I'm going to go back to the championship. I can't trust Wisconsin win a dang championship. Can't trust Marquette. So I'm going with the tried and true, the UW Whitewater Warhawks, who win championships in all different
Did you know Nate Oates has a connection to UW Whitewater, who's the Alabama head coach who's in the Final Four for the men's
basketball. He played at UW Whitewater. And TJ Osselberg, I think
there's a connection there as well.
Yeah, you know, Whitewater produces guys that know how to win when it matters.
So there's Kyle Wallace. The others keep winning, and then he, you know, just flows with the wind. Wearing purple.
I went back to my roots.
I'm going
to
say this, too. Is that the most recent Whitewater Warhawk sweatshirt you have?
Of course.
It looks so old. Can be. The sleeve cuff is chewed up beyond belief.
It looks like a couple dogs got a hold of them.
It sure does. I mean, can you be a real fan of someone and not buy gear in 10 years
This is authentic, paid-for issue gear.
You paid for your own issue gear.
I played Division III football. They gave us T-shirt and shorts and a couple shirts. We didn't get much. We had to pay for these hoodies. So I pay. This is team-issued hoodie that we paid for.
So real blood, sweat, tears, and cash went into that hoodie.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. So, yes, this is about as old as a lot of blood and sweat.
Mostly tears.
I know. It was a lot of blood and sweat. I mean, I didn't bleed too much. I was, you know, scout team. We didn't have to do too much.
That's what I'm saying. A lot of tears. Like, you're getting your butt whooped.
No, they didn't know. You guys want to hear a story? This is when I realized.
Sure, sure. This is Kyle Wallace, the Badger fan turned Marquette fan, and forgetting all of them and becoming his UW Whitewater Warhawk fan.
Oh yeah, going back to my roots of UW Whitewater. Shout out to the, you know, UW Whitewater, multiple time national championship team in football. This is when I realized I didn't like college football and being on a scout team. I remember on the scout team when I covered cornerback, and I covered the receiver the way I would cover the receiver. And I remember I got snapped on and yelled at, "Hey! You need to fall for the play-action fake. That's what they're going to do in the game." I said, what? Fall for the play-action fake? I said, how am I going to get better sitting here doing that? That's what you're supposed to do. And so then, you know, I did what he told me to do. I said, this is so stupid. But because you know what they did in the game? They fell for the play-action fake. I said, my goodness. And that's when I realized I hate scout team. I hate scout because I can't do anything.
Now, a question about scout team. There's always the scout team guy that went too hard, right? He tackled when he shouldn't have tackled.
Oh, even from a basketball perspective, yeah, one that set too many hard screens and Charlie horses.
Kyle, were you that guy?
At first I was. I got yelled, hey! Stay off the ground. I said, what is happening? I said, Doug, like, what am I supposed to do here? Tag off. Break down the tag off, show you in position. I said, well, what? How me showing in position going to prove I'm going to make the tackle? So it wasn't going to last long. If I wasn't going to play, I couldn't be on scout team.
Ezra from Port Washington chimes in. No way Kyle's UW Whitewater sweatshirt is chewed up by dogs. He hates dogs. And that's exactly why I think it's chewed up by dogs.
No, it's not chewed up by a dog. It's chewed up by time. And I don't hate dogs. Let's stop.
We don't need you to backpedal again. Kyle backpedals for a different day.
Dogs, my goodness, stop it.
I mean, you're on air with these takes. You can't just backpedal with everything that you say.
We didn't force you to say those things.
I didn't say
you didn't. I didn't force you to call my baby girl who visited the office on Friday.
I call her
a dang baby.
Dang baby.
I call her a precious baby too.
No, I just remember dang baby.
Just like people.
It's a memorable moment.
800-990-3776 is the ESPN Wisconsin talk and text line. You can get us on YouTube at ESPN Madison, at ESPN Milwaukee. And I guess shout out to Garrett, who is a loyal KBN Nation listener. He says Roll Tide. He is an Alabama fan. So congrats to you and your team making a Final Four, in which we had a local team here with a great opportunity, a great path. They did what they needed to do against Western Kentucky. They did what they needed to do against a Colorado team, and they got matched up against NC State in the Sweet 16. And a lot of people ready for that 6:09 tip-off, including our very own Kyle Wallace, who wore Marquette gear Monday through Friday last week. And The milkshake dump, yes, Joseph, that will be paid off. Of course, Kyle and Brad, and mostly Kyle, who is a fake fan, didn't believe in actually doing the bet. So Brian D., content director of 94.5 ESPN, is going to get a milkshake dumped on him because Kyle is no fun and just wants to be a winner whenever he can. So even when his teams are losing, he's wearing purple.
I'm not willing to take that sacrifice from Marquette.
But I did see something interesting from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy because, you know, Badgers or not, there's been a lot of expectations conversations around the Wisconsin Badgers with them bringing Greg Gard back as the head coach for the 10th year. The lack of second weekend tournament success of the Badgers not being there since 2017. But now we have a different scenario here where you have the Marquette Golden Eagles, who were a 2 seed last year, who lost to the 7 seed Michigan State Spartans. And you bring back the core. You bring back the crew. You bring back the team that sat Tyler Kolek at the end of the regular season when he had a strained oblique, as well as in the Big East tournament, so he could be ready for the NCAA tournament. And from the tears from Shaka and the team about making the Sweet 16 to then shooting an abysmal performance against NC State. And I know NC State's in the Final Four, and I don't want to make this about like, oh, well, maybe NC State was hot. Yeah, they're hot right now. But if we're being honest, I think every Marquette fan would admit this, and anyone with a brain watching the game would admit NC State did not play well. Marquette had as many open looks in rhythm, not just like, oh, like, you know, it was an open look, but it was the wrong guy. Cam Jones, David Joplin, who Brad is familiar with, not from a personal level, but a Brookfield Central grad, who Brad Nortman himself is.
RBC.
I don't know what that means.
All the BC guys know.
Cool.
Losers.
Yeah, right?
Cool.
That made me not like anyone from Brookfield Central.
It reminded me why I don't
Next time we talk to Joe Thomas, I want to know if Joe embraces that weird culty Brookfield Central chant.
Yeah, he absolutely will.
RBC, okay.
But Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, obviously Jen Latta, host of Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, went to Marquette. She's an outspoken fan. Gabe Neitzel does the pre and half of the Marquette Radio Network. They put up a poll earlier today. The 2024 season for the Marquette Golden Eagles was a success or a failure? And before I read the results, I would like to quickly get your responses.
Yeah, looking at me, huh? The Marquette fan.
Yeah, well,
I'll gladly give my response. When I look at the overall...
I said, simply put, a success or a failure?
Success.
That is... amazing.
Emphatic success.
Oh, wow.
Success!
Brad?
It's an absolute failure.
I'm actually with Kyle. I think it was a success. I thought it was a great, successful season. Knowing that you're a 2 seed and you got to the Sweet 16, you sold some shirts for the Sweet 16. I thought everything you could ask from a core of guys that came back. You know, they weren't upset in the locker room at all, ripping jerseys and crying. And look, I've been there, right? Like, you know, it was a success. They were wearing their emotions, you know?
I don't like that whatsoever. What a terrible answer. That was disingenuous.
It wasn't disingenuous.
That wasn't real.
Haven't been to the Sweet 16 since 2013.
At Tennessee.
So for 11 years to get back to the Sweet 16, it was absolutely a success. You know, you won the Big East regular season conference tournament last year and then lost in the second round. And then this year didn't win the Big East regular season, didn't win the Big East tournament, and then got to the Sweet 16. That's a success.
You think a banner and Pfizer is warranted?
I mean, based off all the T-shirt sales.
Oh, my gosh. Stop. Which I'm not going to do. You're not going to disrespect Marquette. We're not going to sit here and ignore the fact.
Kyle, you could have made more shots than Cam Jones and Joplin and Ben Gold and Tyler Kolek and Chase Ross.
I was going to say, you can snap all you want.
You don't even know the damn team.
I saw Chase on Friday night. Here's the thing. At the end of the day, you're right. I probably could have made at least 2 open threes that they missed. But here's the thing. This program, this team, where they were under Woj, Joe, and where they are going and what they have become is something to be proud of. A program is not built in 1 year. We're looking at UConn, and they look like an absolute juggernaut.
So real quick. Since you want to, you gave me the steps to success conversation,
to success.
Like Giannis last year after losing early on and saying, you know, it's not a failure, it's steps to success.
No, it is.
So when you lose Kolek and you lose Cam Jones, and you, and this is all not confirmed, and if you lose Oso, those are three guys that come back, and Marquette isn't very active in the transfer portal, which I think is admirable in how they've been able to build their team. So next year, it's Elite Eight or Final Four. Otherwise, you know what? Kyle's expectations won't be met, and he'll be upset.
I trust in Shaka, and I trust in the young guys on this team to rise to the occasion. Just like a couple years ago, remember when they had Marcus Howard, and people were worried about what's going to happen when Marcus Howard leaves, or when, I forgot what the two brothers' names are, one plays in the NBA, and the other one, I don't know what happened.
Hauser.
Him. Hauser, the Hauser brothers, Sam Hauser and Joey Hauser. When they leave, oh, this program's going to go down. You know what? The program was okay. The program actually got better. I trust in Shaka Smart, because what he has proven to me in 3 years is that he can take over a team, create a foundation, create a vision, and follow through on that vision. He went from
Sweet 16 as a two seed that lost to an 11 seed, bro? He went from making a tournament right now?
To winning a game in the tournament to the Sweet 16. That is going in the right direction. In finance and sales, if somebody saw their portfolio growing just like that, Brad, would they not be happy with
this? This isn't finance, bro. It's not
the same thing, because college teams ebb and flow. You build towards something. This was 2 years in the making to be able to finally capitalize on two straight two seeds in the NCAA tournament.
And you couldn't ask for a better draw from an 11 seed that had lost 14 games during the regular season.
Because you look at those historic years that Ben played in, where the Badgers went to the Final Four and then to the national championship. I think Bo Ryan saw the talent of the team and molded it together so that that group could grow together and maximize their success, and then there's an inevitable step backward when you lose all that talent. For Marquette, it's going to be most likely the same thing, where they tried to keep all this veteran talent together, strike while the iron is hot, high expectations, be the number two seed, and two straight years, all that accounted for was beating a 15 seed, another 15 seed, and a 10 seed. That's all you got. Round of 32 and Sweet 16. That's not nearly enough for years worth of growing a team to be their veteran peak. And then to also be able to just go lose so early in the NCAA tournament. It's not enough.
To me, it is enough. To me, it's good. Obviously, they wanted to have more. But if we're going to sit here and talk about a successful season and not successful season, I refuse to say that this was not a successful season for the overall
program. If you asked Tyler Kolek, and you asked Oso Iguodala, and you asked Cam Jones, hey, do you think this was a successful season?
Well, they're going to
say no, because they lived it and they know it's not a success.
They shot
3 for 1 million against an NC State team that was going under their best shooter in Cam Jones and could have hit a shot to save their life. It was a failure. They had an opportunity. It was a failure. All you did, Kyle, last week was judge the Wisconsin Badgers on their success in the NCAA tournament. And when you have a 2 seed against an 11 seed with an opportunity to go to an elite eight, in which the 1 seed, their best player, got hurt, and you're playing a Duke team that is fraudulent, who's going to be much better next year, you missed your opportunity. It is an absolute failure, no matter what you want to do, no matter what way you want to twist, no matter what way you want to...
Did you say it was a success?
I mean, I was trolling, for goodness sake.
The only reason it feels maybe you could convince yourself that it was a success, a slight success, is because it's been 11 years since any grain of success in the NCAA tournament. That long of hunger and thirst to have any sort of success might make it feel like a success, but given where this team was at, the seed they had, the success of the regular season, you have to go further than the Sweet 16 and beat all double-digit seeds.
Listen, again, this for the players on this team, it's about now, it's about this season, right? That's what it's about.
No, it's about setting the expectation even further, which they had an opportunity to do and failed at.
No, what they did set the expectation. They planted a seed for something to continue to grow. You talk about setting expectations. The young kids on that team, that their entire year, career as a Marquette Golden Eagle, all they know is making the tournament. They are going to be hungry for more. Ben, you play.
I thought that wasn't good enough.
Compare Marquette and Wisconsin, it's not good enough. Because at the end of the day, Marquette was aspiring to get to where Wisconsin was. Now Wisconsin is regressing, and they have fallen.
They still should be aspiring to get to where Wisconsin was. Because
exactly,
if you want to use this Sweet 16, that's the goal. The way that the two Final Four teams worked is the first year was a 2 seed, and there was an opportunity where we were not going to get there when I was a senior. We were down 12 against Oregon. We won that, won a Sweet 16 game, and won an overtime game against an Arizona team. Guess what? That would be the equivalent of what Marquette did last year, utilizing their loss and then coming back with the core and majority of those guys. and then going even further and setting bigger expectations, and they didn't do that. The 2015 team for Wisconsin outdid what 14 did.
I'm looking at
and
it.
And so they failed.
No, you're
they didn't even win
it.
They didn't even win.
You guys are looking
so real
at
quick,
it from this
forget
season.
The tournament for
I'm
a second.
I'm not looking at it from just this one season.
I'm not looking at it either.
From a program as a whole.
From a program as a whole, they won the regular season of the Big East. They won the NCAA or the Big East tournament last year. They didn't do any of those this year, and they only made it to a Sweet 16. So they kind of went backwards, and you're saying they're going up.
With no
memorable. They lost to NC State as a two seed.
NC
you can't
State,
justify
NC State
anything.
Is going to be playing next weekend.
It has
State,
nothing to do
NC
with
State
what they're doing. It has everything to do with what Marquette
baby was
did.
Born. That's how long it's been.
Yeah, see, you will move the goalpost to make yourself feel good, even though you're a fraudulent fan and are trying to set expectations for a team you don't actually care about,
I do
and that's
care.
How fraudulent you are.
I care about Marquette. They are a good basketball program. I like the direction they're going. I like their coach, and I like their style of play as well. So I am going to look at it from the glass half full that this team is laying.
What's their identity?
They get up and down the court.
This, oh, great. How did that work out?
I think there's only two games this year they scored less than 60 points.
Oh, pick the wrong time to do it.
Yeah, as a follow-up, Kyle, are you officially off the bandwagon now? Because you are a Marquette bandwagon fan. They lost. Are you off?
I am still on the bandwagon.
Oh, come
you
on.
Can't
jump
be, you can't the be way, on both.
What do you mean? Don't tell me.
So you're a full-time
don't
fan.
Don't tell me, a born Wisconsinite, who the heck I could cheer for, okay? I am a Wisconsin Badgers fan.
So when they were losing. Like,
when Marquette was losing?
Yeah, where
I
were
was,
you?
I was frustrated because I worked at the university. It was bad for business. It was terrible business. That's why they had to fire him.
So it had nothing to do with your fandom. It had everything to do with your pockets.
Well, then, yes. I was cheering for them then because I need for them to be successful. But when Marquette is down, I am not with Marquette. Marquette is up, and their future is brighter than a Wisconsin.
No one likes
future.
Anybody without a backbone. It used to be me, but I'm so glad you took that from me. 800-990-3776. He blows with the wind. He swims in the sea, in the ocean, just going with the tidal waves. That's Kyle Wallace. Brad Nortman, who gets it. You know, it's nice to have somebody on the show, Brad, who just understands success and failure because you've been through the ups and downs. You've been in a locker room where you understood when the season was a success or failure. Unfortunately, we have to talk to a fan that can change his mind any single second throughout the show. I'm Ben Bruss. We are Kyle Bruss and Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin, 800-990-ESPN. My family was a big bunch of jerks yesterday, putting me on blast at the Easter dinner table, pressuring me into doing things that I want to make decisions for myself. Families are the worst. Next.
You're listening to Kyle Bruston Nortman.
Listen, Diana, that's her name. Listen, we all about positive manifestation. I like you, Diana. All it is negative.
Diana.
Criticize.
Dirty Diana.
I love you, Kyle.
Love you too, girl.
I love you, Kyle.
I love you too. That's what I'm talking about. The real Packer Nation.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. All the sounds you love of summer are back.
It's baseball season. Opening day in Milwaukee on 94.5 ESPN is brought to you by National Liquor Mart. Tune in all day long on April 2nd as we get you ready for the Milwaukee baseball home opener. And make sure you're stocked up on all your beverage needs for baseball season and make a stop into National Liquor Mart on 16th and National. They have the coldest beer and a huge liquor selection with great pricing. Get ready, baseball fans. Opening day in Milwaukee on 94.5 ESPN is brought to you by National Liquor Mart.
Stay up to date on the Green and Gold all off season. The Green and Gold Fix podcast is brought to you by Potawatomi Casino Hotel. Luxury stay, elite play. Unwind in sophisticated comfort. Win big, dine, and experience the events in Milwaukee.
Right now, the prices of diamonds are probably the lowest we'll see in our lifetime.
Diamond prices are low, low, low. Here's why.
It was hard to meet new people during COVID.
When a person meets their soulmate, they usually get engaged about 39 months later.
People started dating again only about 36 months ago.
Most of the people who got engaged during COVID
or immediately after COVID
were already in a relationship before the COVID lockdown began.
The Wall Street Journal even published a story about all of this.
Low sales of engagement rings created a worldwide oversupply of diamonds.
But now, engagement ring sales are beginning to pick up again.
By the end of next spring, this temporary oversupply will be gone.
And diamond prices will start climbing like crazy.
If you ever wanted to own a big diamond, this is the year to do it.
Find the Kesslers nearest you at KesslersDiamonds.com.
If you want to own a big diamond, the time is now.
This wasn't how Patrick here in Milwaukee pictured himself in retirement. Instead of playing golf every day, he could barely walk because of severe knee pain.
It hampered everything because it hurt to walk around the golf course. It hurt to swing, just pretty much hurt doing anything.
But the groundbreaking regenerative treatments at QC Kinetics changed everything for Patrick. QC Kinetics uses your body's own healing properties to help repair and restore damaged tissue in your knees, hips, back, and shoulders. No surgery, no drugs, no downtime.
The turnaround's been amazing. From where I was to where I am now. I've gone from a 15 handicap down to a 7 handicap. That's because my knees allow me to play golf like I haven't been able to play probably in 15 years.
Don't let joint pain keep you from doing what you love. Call QC Kinetics today for your complimentary consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Multiple sclerosis is an unpredictable, often disabling disease of the central nervous system. We need to show support to people with MS, and one way is through Walk MS, which is brand new in 2024. We embrace and are committed to bringing our entire MS community together, representative of all the various dimensions of our community, so that everyone feels at home and supported by the National MS Society. The excitement is building for the new Walk MS. Come see the community come together like never before. Visit walkms.org today and plan to join us around Wisconsin.
People across Wisconsin are enjoying the rewards, stability, and flexibility of a career in healthcare. Why not you? WISC Caregiver Careers can get you started as a certified direct care professional. You'll learn the skills you need to make life better for older adults or people with a disability. All training is free and online, plus earn $500 in bonuses. Start your new career. Sign up today at WISCCaregiverCDCP.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Department of Health Services.
Don't you wish your life came with a warning app?
That dog does not want to be petted.
Well, life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome, but prediabetes does. Take the one-minute test today at doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its Prediabetes Awareness Partners.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
It could be that somebody, body, keep me satisfied. Hear me breathing, breathing.
800-990-ESPN. Kyle, do you know what the word fickle means?
Yeah, Luke.
That's your sports fandom, fickle.
Yeah. Wow. I am not fickle.
Ernie in a barn near Elroy. Does Kyle realize Shaka Smart didn't even recruit all three of those that are leaving?
I thought he brought Kolick in, no? Oh, so Kolick came with Wojo when he transferred in?
There's one of them. One of the three, I believe, he had influence on. But he's like the Bruce Weber taking the talent from Bill Self and coaching him. But not to a Final Four like Bruce Weber did for Illinois.
No, I would say that Shaka did a great job because you know what? I look at the team that I really love, and he came to know what the kids he do recruit.
You're the best. 800-990-3776. That's the ESPN Wisconsin Talk and Text Line. I'm Ben Brust, alongside Kyle Wallace, who is fickle with his fandom, and now he's rocking, in his opinion, a real championship organization slash college in the UW Whitewater football squad.
Alma mater, I can play. Like you guys, you know, live Wisconsin, I play for Whitewater as well.
When's the last time they won a championship?
Whitewater won a championship in 2000 and... Oh, this might have been a while now.
That's Brad Nortman, second place Brad, asking Kyle the toughies, and Chris Larson back there running the show. You can get us on YouTube at ESPN Madison, at ESPN Milwaukee. But I tell you what, this has happened to you guys at, like, it could be any holiday, right? Christmas, Thanksgiving, Easter, 4th of July, whenever you get together with family. I'm the youngest, so the older siblings turn into complete jerks. With my lovely daughter and my lovely girlfriend in attendance, I think it was the liquid courage that got into them. I'm getting roasted on Easter brunch, dinner, whatever time we had. Next thing I know, I'm getting engagement questions.
Oh wow.
What?
Yeah,
on Easter.
On Easter,
he is risen front of everybody.
In front of everybody.
Oh,
is that Willie and Tosh would say, is that IPT? Is that in poor taste to put your man on blast at Easter?
Let's get nuts.
You know what? I'm on your family side on this one.
What?
It's about day time that we had the conversations with Ben Prost.
Is that Lizzo?
It is.
I didn't even know. I just quoted that.
It's about dang time.
I don't know that song. All right, well, I just quoted Lizzo without even knowing. It's about dang time that you were put on the spotlight and be able to put some pressure on you to finally get on one knee.
I gave baby a home. I gave baby girl a home.
You know what? This is what you need. Sometimes you need a little peer pressure to be able to push someone in the right direction. Yes, you gave baby and mama a home, and yes, you're a great father and boyfriend, but that boyfriend's got to be husband now soon.
But
you need that push, Ben Brush.
Just because you got married at 24 doesn't mean we all have to do it Brad's way.
Right.
Isn't there something about the fact that, like, you know, these are all big moments. Buying a house, big moment. Having a child, big moment. Getting engaged, it could be 2024, it could be 25, it could be 26. But whenever that big moment is, I mean, that could be...
It's too late for you for 25, 26.
Hey, take it easy over there. I thought you were... My overall point is if you buy a house and have a child and get engaged in the same year within 3 to 4 months that I'm being pressured to do so, don't we think, like, you know, maybe it might be a okay thing to space it out?
Yeah, you know what? Let me apologize for you, Ben, that you had to deal with all that.
Thank you.
Your family needs to have their priorities straight. On the day we're supposed to celebrate the Lord Jesus Christ, they want to bring up some other stuff. It should be focused on that, being thankful for the life that we have, but instead they want to charge you up about getting a wedding ring and even set you up and let you know they're going to ask the question. They should be happy.
How do they not have the cash?
Hard times is hard.
Here's why they did it.
Interest rates are out the room.
Here's why they did it. Here's why they know Ben's family knows Ben more than anybody, more than you and I, right? They've known him since the day he was born. They know that he's just going to continue to skate by.
Is that what I'm doing, Brad? Yeah. Is that your opinion?
Where were you at dinner yesterday?
Because you would have fit in just well with my family.
I'm pushing this as long as I possibly can until there's no more escape, until there's no more ability to push it off any longer. And they're saying, Ben, baby of the family, we will not stand for it. You need a little bit of peer pressure. You need a little bit of push, and allow us to do that in front of everybody, including your girlfriend and baby.
Don't I hold all the leverage here?
Explain.
I don't know.
Explain. I'm with you, but let me figure this out.
I think they hold the leverage, but if we're going to really get down to it.
Hey, you know, I really didn't like the way that you were talking to me right there. That's a month added on the engagement.
That could be a little bit of, like, emotional manipulation.
Oh, wow. Maybe I should shut up.
Why should you shut up, Kyle?
I was going to agree. You know, you got to hurt. You got to listen. If I'm going to give up my life, you know,
you're going to give up your.
Oh, you should be so lucky as to have a woman like your woman and your woman. You should say that again for the record, Kyle.
If
I'm going to gladly give up my independence, it's got to be earned, right? It's a tough decision to make. And for his family to not even consider Ben's feeling, think about what he's giving up, think about all he's given to. They have a niece, a granddaughter, a beautiful baby because of him. They have a nice home they could come
to. Get married. Point at the finger.
All this stuff costs money, and all this stuff is done with love. At the end of the day, they have started a beautiful family. I know, you know, he didn't do it the way that some people think you should do it, but that is okay.
Austin chimes in.
He's going to get it when he get it.
Arguably three of the largest moments of an individual's life. That is a lot to do in 6 months, and it might not be healthy.
Thank you.
I think it is healthy because you're both talking about your girls who need to earn your love. That's the exact opposite of conditional or unconditional love that marriage is.
Pot calling kettle black. Let's take a quick time out here. Last time I checked, I don't know if they were married when he went to Charlotte to play for the Panthers, but she was, Lexi is now wife, was running around town with no car and fending for herself.
She the one who had unconditional love.
I don't have rebuttal to that. That was 10 years ago. But that is very fair. And Lexi proved that she was going to be with me through thick and thin.
Proved. We earned. We're waiting for the proof. We even know the proof from my girl, my baby. She has proven so much. It is me, not her.
Yeah, I should probably shut up. She is a wonderful mother. But I'm just saying.
I think it's time. Why is the
family always have to do this? Like, can't they just be happy, right? Like, We are happy. We have a home. Maybe she's not happy. Maybe she wants to ring. I'm sure she does. We have a home. We have a beautiful young daughter who is 9 weeks old. And we want to throw in the emotion of an engagement within all the last 3 months.
It's inconsiderate and inconsiderate and insensitive of your family to bring that up and to and just bum rush you like that with
like,
that type of question.
You spend time with your girlfriend during Easter?
Yeah, she came up. My family didn't ask that question because they knew was not the right time and
you
place
enjoyed
to do
that. Your time, didn't
you? I enjoyed eating my food. I enjoyed the conversation. I didn't get bombarded with any ridiculous questions on that day. If they truly cared about it, then somebody would take you to the side and say, hey, little bro,
what's going? Or call me after,
yeah,
like, hey,
so
no,
every every time we're with her, we think you're the dumbest person in the entire world. You should get a ring pop and put it on her and make like,
yeah,
and then go, and then when you have the like, you know,
they're holding they're holding you guys accountable. You
no,
guys need the push.
They can do that outside of Easter. I want to enjoy time with my family.
Yeah,
not be
no,
the,
clearly
not be,
on your own accord. There's not enough incentive behind you both to actually take that next step and do it. So
Brad,
you need people
need you
in
stop.
Your life holding you accountable to take that next step and value your women the way they should be valued.
Brad, you are not the boys right now. You are not gang right now, Brad. You have turned on us. You have made us into looking like bad men. I don't like that, Brad. We were cool until now.
Yeah, he's trying to act all Mr. Perfect over there.
Strike this off from the record.
You guys should be as eager as possible to get married.
We need to take this off the podcast. This segment does not need to be on the podcast. Take it off the stream as well.
Mr. 36, you're man enough to put a baby in her. You're man enough to put a ring on her.
Oh,
powerful.
Wow.
That is kind of powerful. How did baby mama react to the... I can't read from this far.
To the Inquisition.
Inquisition.
Actually, I'd love to know that.
I was just making sure I got it right. I can read it.
I'm sure she handled it. I'm sure she handled
all
pure
we talked
grace
about for
class.
The last hour and 10 minutes on the way back in the car was that exact same conversation. I said, if you keep this conversation up, 2028's looking more like it.
Dang.
Savage.
I guess hold that power while you got it.
Lab grown.
Don't even get me started on lab grown.
All right, you don't get Brad started on lab grown.
No, Brad has already eviscerated us in this conversation.
If you're going to value your women, you're going to devalue the marriage by getting her a fake diamond.
Oh,
just
wow.
Because they make fake steak doesn't mean you can call it a steak and you can enjoy
they
it
make
when
fake
you eat it.
Steak?
And it's the only steak that she's ever going to eat.
That's
the
vegan steak.
They make lab grown.
Oh, I thought he was saying he was making, they were cloning cows or something.
There's like lab grown steak. It doesn't mean it's steak. And if it's the only steak you're ever going to eat, you better get you a good steak, a Wagyu steak. If you get something that's really good, I don't want to see that you guys cheap your way into marriage.
Oh,
you
wow.
Did, I become so judgmental.
We're going to be right back on Kyle Bruston Norman because now he just didn't offend me. He offended a lot of people upstairs in our office listening. That's next.
This is Kyle Bruston Norman, KBN.
See you again.
Oh, you need some.
And then I said, I appreciate it. The same goes for you. Let me know if anything I can do for you. Obviously, what am I going to do for Russell Wilson? You're the man.
Babysit his kids.
Fake relationship of all time.
No
way. On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
They say seeing is believing. And when you see what's inside at American Place Casino, you better believe you're gonna love it. Because when it comes to amazing gaming, we're a real game changer. With the most exciting of table games like blackjack, craps, and roulette, the newest slots, a sports book, restaurants, bars, and more. So if you're ready for excitement, we'll see you soon. American Place Casino. Change the game.
Must be 21 years of age or older. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem, crisis counseling and referral services can be accessed by calling 1-800-GAMBLER, 1-800-426-2537.
The only thing that tops our selection is your savings discount liquor. If it's a celebrate or tailgate, when you're gonna recreate upstate. If it's a holiday, birthday, any date, you can save at discount liquor.
This is Marie from Discount Liquor. The home opener at AmFam Field is almost here, and we want to help you stock up for your tailgate party. Whether you need beer by the barrel or case, including a huge selection of craft brews, or your favorite bottle of liquor or wine, we have everything you need at the lowest prices in town. And you'll save a lot of money here at Discount Liquor. Visit us at 51st and Oklahoma in Milwaukee, and on Barstow and Main in downtown Waukesha. Or go to DiscountLiquorInc.com. Voted best liquor store in Milwaukee again.
The only thing that tops our selection is your savings.
Check out all of our weekly specials at DiscountLiquorInc.com.
Discount Liquor.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Injuries happen.
but you don't have to play in pain or stay on the sidelines. Whether it's your kids dealing with a sports injury, college athletes, or the rest of us weekend warriors, the experts at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin will quickly diagnose your problem, lay out a treatment plan that works for you, and get you back in the game. They fixed my knee. My mother-in-law is back on the dance floor with a new hip. These are the experts you can trust. Visit orthowisconsin.com.
Hey, it's Kyle Walls for Universal Windows Direct. I've been telling you that windows from Universal perform better and last longer. Call today at 414-410-2000 to schedule your free in-home estimate today. And for every two windows you buy, you get the next two free. Plus, a free upgrade to triple pane glass, and they'll double your energy tax credit. Restrictions do apply. Tell them I told you to call and get an additional $250 off your next project. For the last windows you'll ever need, go to UniversalWindowsDirect.com, and like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
Change the way you do business and take more control of the payment process with Fifth Third Bank's treasury management solutions. Their market expertise and managed services streamline the entire payment process and integrate with your existing systems, giving you more control than ever. With their suite of payment solutions, you will soon recognize new revenue sources that can save time, offset operating costs, and improve the bottom line, all customized for your business. Fifth Third Bank National Association, custom solutions built around your goals. Member FDIC.
What is dedication?
My daughter started making necklaces. She makes what we call affirmation fashion. I tell her every day that your black is beautiful. Your black is beautiful. And if there's anything better than being beautiful, it's being smart. If there's anything better than being smart, it's being kind. And reaffirming that every day is our method of making sure her chin never drops. My dad wasn't around, and I remember riding a bike and falling off and cutting myself, and me never would just want to get back on it. People ask, how your children learn how to ride a bike, and you didn't. I didn't teach them. I just created an environment where they taught themselves, and all I had to do was be there.
That's dedication. Visit fatherhood.gov to hear more. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Okay.
It's just a behind-the-scenes discussion with Kyle Brustin-Orman. Talking rings, talking lab-grown, talking regular mine diamonds.
I ain't getting married. What y'all just told me, I can't afford it. Hell, I'm trying to eat.
Hey, we won a couple Ben same-game parlays. You start a little piggy bank.
Yeah, $26 is nice. Shout out to
Kyle. Oh, I owe you $36. That's right. I got some cash for you.
I had a good weekend, too.
You did?
Yeah. Oh. Hit with Underdog and hit with Pato.
Hey.
It's a good day.
Look at you doing well over there,
$100.
Kyle. So I'm glad that Kyle left the room because I saw on YouTube as we were discussing the fact that on Easter dinner brunch thing, my family put me through the ringer with my lovely girlfriend and baby right in front of me. Mr. 36 says, they didn't bring up marriage because they didn't want you two together. And that, I think that's in reference to Kyle's great Easter dinner last night.
Oh, me? No. My parents. Dang. Wait a minute. Let me be honest.
Wow.
I'm a mama's boy. And so I ain't gonna lie. Mama Wallace is not too eager to see any of her boys get married like that.
Because
you want to be replaced?
No. She would happily see us get married. She wants grandkids. But, I think she's a... She's a little nervous, you know, and not nervous about what? My dad wouldn't care whatsoever.
Nervous about what?
That she won't get as much as attention as she probably got before.
Okay, I didn't know if you were saying she was nervous about who you're dating.
Not that. She's low. No, she loves her.
Mm-hmm.
She does.
How come she didn't bring up marriage at Easter like they did for me?
Because my family has decorum as respectful of exactly.
We're just a bunch of animals.
Yeah, well, y'all are getting married.
Yeah. We're eating beef tenderloin that barely cooked, like, get married, you know? Like, y'all are having a nice dinner, nice little.
My parents know not to disrespect me like that.
800-990-3776. Look, like I said, I have a plan.
2025. God, 2025.
Yeah, it's only next
year. KBN was full of men who's willing to step up to the plate, be the men that the women need them to be, and get them.
Thank you, Chris.
And when it comes around, I want to hear.
No, I think he's saying. I think he's saying we're not the men.
Yeah,
no,
you're not
I think
the men.
I thought he was buzzing you.
I thought KBS.
Who are you buzzing? Brad or us?
I'm buzzing you guys.
Oh, you're what?
I don't want to hear a dang thing about any lab grown diamonds on this show. From you guys.
Well, based off what y'all just told me,
I do the real thing.
Ain't nothing. Only thing real about me is gonna be my marriage because that ring is gonna be lab grown. Watch it get grown, baby. Look, I took pictures. Look at your ring becoming a diamond.
Kyle's not gonna tell her. Be like, hey,
this is the real thing.
Hey, baby, look at this thing.
No,
hey,
look at it flourish.
You're like, hey. This is a diamond, but it's fake.
No, it's not fake.
It's not fake.
It's lab grown.
Excuse me. That is not fair to say.
Thank you.
It's lab grown. Lab grown.
I am going to be very open and very honest because the last thing I want to do is start this rest of my life off with a lie because eventually she would find out because she would be talking about it and somebody would ask her the question and she'll say, oh, it's real. And then they would be like, I don't know. I ain't going to embarrass her like
that. All right, so I didn't think we were going to go here, but I had to because when Kyle is outwardly... So, there, Brad, he'll do some things. Kyle Wallace, Ben Brust, Brad Nortman here. Kyle Brust and Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. On YouTube, at ESPN Madison, at ESPN Milwaukee, you can hit us 800-990-3776. Kyle will audibly gasp or like make a and it could be about... personal life, it could be about work, it could be about the show, and it leaves us guessing. But this one was, I knew what it was about. And all I have to say is Jake Bates, and he pulled off in the UFL a 64-yard field goal with 3 seconds left to give the Michigan Panthers an 18-16 win over the St. Louis Battlehawks. And I wish you could see Kyle's face on YouTube right now because he's just upset.
Disappointing. This dude who nobody's ever heard of in the UFL, UXFL, whatever.
Exactly.
Whatever they call it now, I'll read the headline, says 64-yard game winning field. I said, what the hell? He hit a 64-yard and my kicker can't hit a 45-yard? When we up? Like, this is the best we can do.
How about an extra point?
Right. Yeah. I mean, this kid is in 64-yarders, and my kicker, I'm praying. My coach literally said he is praying every time he sends him out there. And this kid from off the street that probably works a regular job between, you know, off-season for them, he's kicking 64-yard bombs.
You know what?
Sign
literally,
him.
Literally you know what made the extra my point favorite life. Point about that was I think Matt LaFleur was literally speaking for every single Packer fan when Tom Rinaldi went against Matt LaFleur's wishes of bringing that on the air because Kyle naturally was like, I'm praying. And he goes, you know what? It's not just me. It's the damn head coach.
If anything, the head coach should have doubled down on it, Matt LaFleur. He'd be able to connect with fans better. I think he'd be able to more speak your language, Kyle Wallace, because he'd be like, thank you, Matt. I'm feeling the same exact thing as you are.
I hope, Matt.
And this is in reference to Anders Carlson, obviously the Packers kicker having a rough rookie season in the bottom. He is the bottom when it comes to the statistical category of extra points and 40-plus yard field goals in his rookie campaign.
Now, we know Matt LaFleur has no decision-making power over player personnel, but I bet you him and Goody are friends on social media, and he probably saw that field goal kick and just DM'd to him and said, hey, man, that's a good-looking kicker, ain't it? Just to kind of put the little message out there that maybe we should consider signing this Jake Bowers, whatever, Jake Bats.
Jake Bates, you learned his name faster than Anderson Carlson, as you call him.
Yeah, maybe we should think about trying to sign this kid. 64-yard field goal, we need to sign him now.
I mean, honestly,
make a 60-yard.
What's it going to hurt to bring him in? What's it going to hurt?
Nothing.
Greg Joseph, Jake Bates. He'd probably come in for a tryout and make more than he's making in the UFL.
I probably would, honestly. And with a little bit of maybe a threesome kicker competition, maybe that would really put the pressure on Carlson. I just can't believe if you look at it too, dude drained it. It was on a line through the uprights. Well, how would you feel if we walked out Carlson there for a 64-yard field goal? Would you say, hey, other team,
he'd
put
be
a returner?
Like, oh, hell no.
Put a returner back
get a guy
there?
Back there.
I would say, what are we doing? Field position is important. I work with a guy named Bradley Nortman, phenomenal punter. He would say, hey, we got this jack-leg kicker. We need to punt. Put me in. That's terrible. That'd be stupid. If Packers kick a field goal over 45 yards, you might as well punt.
Honestly, though, that is a huge debate as to like when they moved on from Mason Crosby. He was reliable, but he didn't have a big leg towards the end of his career. I mean, he was his last season, he was really efficient, just couldn't have anything beyond 50 plus. Otherwise, it was like kind of like, all right, we're going for around fourth down, anywhere from the 35 to the 46, 47 on the other opposing field.
We'd be going. We would have went to the NFC Championship game if we had Mason Crosby.
What about? No,
What do you mean?
Maybe.
What do you mean?
I guess.
I mean, he missed a kick for the Giants too. Like
he
was also
been
aging
all year long.
Would Jake Bates have made that?
Some guy we didn't know until this morning.
He made a 64-yard. That boy got confidence. All right, he got confidence. He probably would have made that easily. And he's going to be kicking the NFL next year.
Oh no! Justin chimes in. He makes it even better. I don't know if this is true, but I'm going to trust KBN Nation. The best part about kicker Jake Bates is that he hasn't kicked a field goal since high school.
No, that's not. That can't be true.
You are a
dang
lie.
That cannot be true.
That can't. That has to be false.
Is that going
to
make you even more upset?
That would mean the Packers need to hold a kicking tryout. That's what that means to me.
Yeah. Oh, oof.
Brad,
I think he's right.
Oh, no!
I saw you in like.
Yeah, he was a kicker in Arkansas, and you just did kickoffs.
Kickoff
you
specialist.
Didn't do field goals.
Oh no!
Kickoff specialist.
And apparently, several NFL teams have already been in contact with him, including the Lions. I guess.
Made it in their building.
Dog, he could have made that from what, 67?
See, now, I'm not going to stand for this. Jacob in the 2-6-0. I'm not saying, well, okay.
He also played soccer for two seasons as well. Central Arkansas.
This is context, I guess. I'm not going to get mad at him. When it comes to Jake Bates, I don't even know his name anymore. I'm not saying it'll happen, but Anderson Carlson. I'm now calling him the wrong name.
It doesn't matter.
Because
what his name
Anders Carlson's brother was crap his rookie year, too. The Vikings got rid of him. Now look at him. I don't have Daniel Carlson on Anders' brother's stats in front of me from when he was in college. Anders was bad at Auburn, and he was bad his rookie year. Just because you're in the family tree, this is nepotism not working out for the Green Bay Packers and Rich Bisaccia. 800-990-3776. We are Kyle Bruston-Ortman across ESPN Wisconsin. Yes, Kyle.
Dan Carlson left Auburn as a school and SEC record holder in career scoring. Kicking points as well, and field goals, 92, and consecutive PATs made 198. His brother was not him.
Looking
at Andrew's stats here, 79 of 110 in Alabama for a 72%
Auburn
field goal percentage at Auburn. Yeah.
Ooh, that's pretty bad.
Yeah, very bad. Yeah, did you not know he was that bad in college?
I didn't. I honestly felt prey to nepotism as well. I thought, oh, okay.
Big leg, 73% at Auburn.
72%.
Oh, God, even worse.
That's pretty bad.
Bring in Jake Bates. More Kyle Bruston-Ortman across ESPN Wisconsin, some KBN Academy. Plus, at 6 o'clock, we got a damn good game. I mean, I love when we can go Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then have a Monday 6 o'clock game, Iowa-LSU, where I'm tuning in, you're tuning in, and if you're listening and you don't know, you should tune in. That's all next on Kyle Bruston-Ortman.
This is Kyle Bruston-Ortman.
Giannis does look like a longer, you know, he beats on his body, like, kind of plays so rough you wonder about. Shut up, Max. Yeah.
I'm not letting that one pass.
Yeah, I just realized beats on his body. Like, I meant, like, physical.
I don't know what y'all talking about.
Physicality down there.
Oh, come on, Kyle.
No, you guys are, I don't know what it is, but I'm sure your minds are in a gutter. Grow up.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Football guy.
What the hell happened to Bucky on your hat?
Football guy.
A lot of wear and tear for old B.
Coming at it from different views.
I'm just saying, he's well-worn. I mean, his face is missing. Okay, well, it's probably time for me to freshen that up. Bucky wants to flip you off right now.
Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Also sponsored by Coors Light. Weekdays 9 to noon on 94.5 ESPN. And available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
Life's better with American Family Insurance. Because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
For over 50 years, Cousin Sob's has celebrated and embraced the traditions of their home state of Wisconsin. And now, Cousins will be honoring a Wisconsin tradition like no other with their pull tab giveaway promo. Now through April 30th, while supplies last, guests will receive a Cousin's pull tab with a sub or or a sub in a bowl purchase for a chance to win Cousin Subs for a year and much more. For additional information and official rules, visit CousinSubs.com/pulltabs. One pull tap per customer per transaction per day. To receive a pull tap with no purchase necessary, see official rules.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with 2 decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Some things are fine to buy from a vending machine, but despite what a certain national online company tells you, a car's not one of them.
Let's see. Cheese doodles, Mr. Nougat bar. Oh, here we go. Green four-door hatchback. Honey, we're gonna need some more quarters.
Sure, they make it seem convenient, but it won't be so convenient if you have a problem with the vehicle you buy. And if it's after 7 days, good luck. Adam member dealers also let you search online. And unlike those national companies, you get to see the vehicle in person and test drive it before you buy it. You also have the assurance that the vehicle's been thoroughly tested, and if any issue does come up, your local Adam member dealer is right here to service it and can also provide low financing and top dollar for your trade. Think about that before you take a chance with their so-called vending machine.
What? It's stuck! No! Oh, rats!
Start your search at ADAMM.com.
Hey, hungry? And your heart is ticking for chicken? Well, take a quick turn into Quick Trip, because we got
no ordinary chicken.
Yeah, go wild with wings, next level super wings, with trusty Sidekick and sauces. Or let's talk tender, quick chick tenders. Love me tenders. Love me some quick tenders. Ours are bigger, better, tastier. Or if you're feeling good old school comfort fried chicken, we got it. Hand breaded, down homier than anywhere. Quick Trip, saving your nuggets from ordinary.
You're listening to Kyle Brust and Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Your hands are steady in your sleeping night. How did you turn your heart to stone? I don't
Kurt Kyle Wallace, a little Beyonce coming in. Is this the country album?
This is
this don't sound very country to me.
Cowboy Carter.
Just because the word cowboy's in it doesn't mean it's country.
You're going to be a full-on country music fan before you know it. That's all you need is a little taste.
I like some country. I do. But this one is...
This is trap country.
It got the violin. It's trap country.
This is like a fusion at best.
I don't dislike the vibe, but it's not country.
He said, giddy up, giddy up. That's country. What R&B thing is about giddy up, giddy up?
She wore a cowboy hat.
That's the thing. If you wear a cowboy hat,
Kyle's coming in with a cowboy hat tomorrow.
Giddy up,
I'm
giddy
country
up.
As ever. I'm Kyle Wallace.
Promotional photo.
See? Chaps, wow.
You know she looked good. Chaps.
All right, take it easy over there. It's time for the KBN Academy.
In radio, our goal's pretty simple.
Just so you know, you really suck.
Have an A show or an F show.
Hey, I'll decide who sucks around here.
The same goes for topics in this next segment. This is the KBN Academy.
Those that can't do, teach.
It is the KBN Academy, where Ben Bruss, Kyle Wallace, Brad Nortman, we are your professors. We are tough graders. We give A's or F's. There's no B's, C's, or D's, or anywhere else in between. Chris Larson, you're going to ask some questions. We'll answer.
All right, let's start off here in the KBN Academy. Nearly 1 in 5 recent U.S. graduates said they are least confident in handling automotive maintenance, such as changing a tire or their oil, according to a survey. ARF, you know how to change a tire or your oil in your car.
Now, I just have a question here. They are least confident in handling automotive maintenance. Was there other options within the survey?
That was just a couple of the things they mentioned was changing a tire, changing their oil, because those are the most common and basic of auto repair maintenance.
So I was just taught how to change a tire. So I'd say F. If life or death came, I could figure out how to change the tire. I now know where to put the jack, like the lug nuts. I get the whole thing. But like changing the oil, what I don't like, it's oh, to me it's outlandish to think that somebody needs to know how to change the oil. Because like for me, I pay for convenience. Or maybe this is just me being me, right? I know you can go to a local automotive store, get the oil type, know how many quarts of oil go in your vehicle, but you gotta drain the oil, then you gotta clean, like have a new filter, then you gotta put the oil in, like. Why would I do that when I can sit in my damn car while they change the damn oil?
I totally agree. I could do a flat tire. That, no problem. That's an A. But it's a big-time F to anything more than more windshield wiper fluid and just pouring the motor oil in there. Changing the oil. I mean, there's like synthetic oil. There's normal oil. These engines aren't getting any simpler. They're getting more and more complicated. If I would rather just pay someone, whatever it is, $80 to change the oil, while I sit in that nice lounge, sip some coffee, and go on my phone.
You don't got to leave some of them.
That's true.
I know the ones where I'm just sitting there, I'm jamming out, talking to people, making friends.
That sounds way better than learning a whole new trade just to save $80 or whatever.
I know, and then the chances that I mess it up too.
Yeah, and then your engine is smoking down the road. That's exactly what you want, is my hands on my own engines. You do not want
that. I'm curious what Mr. Warhawk is going to say.
Yeah, I
see judgment too.
Very judgmental.
Man, we are not our grandfathers, obviously. Men have just fallen so far.
Well, what are you? You know how to change your oil?
I don't know how to do it, but I'm not going to say I wish I did know how to do it. I would feel more like an independent individual if I knew how to do this.
Did you know that if you want to be that independent individual, you can learn?
Yeah, YouTube.
There's still time.
I made the decision currently now to choose not to because I can invest the $50 that my car takes for oil change and tire rotation. So I enjoy spending a little money for that to make sure it's done right. But to sit here and act like it's not a bit, who would want to learn how to do that? Why is that? I don't know.
I definitely sound a little snobby there.
Yeah, somebody who just decides that they want to take, you know, their own destiny in their vehicle in their own hands. Maybe want to learn a new skill. You guys are ridiculous, man. Millennials, Gen Xers, all pansies now.
Don't put millennials and Gen Xers in the same category.
We're both Gen Z, you mean?
Gen Z.
Gen Z's pansies too. Like I'm telling you.
Well, that's a given.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. We're all wusses.
Can't say that. I had to dump you. No, you can't say that.
Yeah, Kyle.
When did?
Just stop and move on. Gen Z's and millennials are weak sauce.
Weak sauce.
They're soft.
Soft.
You can get your point across. I'm trying to help you get this. No, we're done.
Sucks.
We're done. Yeah. We'll be back in 2 minutes. Kyle Bruston Ortman. I quit.
Hi, this is John Neal, CPA, founder of Right Choice Tax Resolution, and best-selling author on how to have less stress with the IRS. It's 2024 and an election year. The politicians are out there promising things they won't deliver. One thing is certain. Taxes are what pays for those promises. The IRS collects those taxes, and man, can they be brutal. My latest book has advice on what to do to avoid trouble with the IRS. We help you file back tax returns, get liens released, set up payment plans, represent you in audits, and get penalties reduced or eliminated. Some recent clients we helped include getting a $40,000 tax bill reduced by $32,000, filing a 2020 tax return to get a $7,000 refund, and negotiating a payment plan for $250 a month on a $30,000 tax bill. Make the right choice. Go to rightchoicetax.us to book a call or in-person meeting right now. We know you want to take the first step in getting the IRS off your back so you can live again. That's rightchoicetax.us.
Haul away big deals this Thursday through Sunday at Fleet Farm's Truckload Savings Event. Like 40-pound bags of black oil sunflower seed on sale for $14.99. Save on a Blackstone 28-inch griddle with cover and accessories, just $249.99. Pick up 4 bags of garden soil on sale for $10. And save on 40 pounds of Morton water softening pellets for only $5.79. Stock up on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm.
It is finally here. I'm talking about the Guinness Basketball Hour. This is your chance to enjoy a free pint of Guinness at select locations throughout southeastern Wisconsin. Stop by Maxwell's in Cedarburg on Thursday from 5 p.m. until 6 p.m. and enjoy a free Guinness pint.
beer.
Also enjoy Guinness at Hot House, Deer Camp, Lucky Chuckies, and Magoo's. Receive one free pint of Guinness during the Guinness Basketball Hour. This Thursday is your last chance to enjoy that free pint, so stop by Maxwell's in Cedarburg during the 5 p.m. hour.
Hey, this is Gabe Neitzel. You're listening to 94.5 ESPN, WKTI and WKTI HD, Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station.
Broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
You know, I mentioned earlier, this is one of my favorite times personally, with the personal connection to the NCAA tournament. And actually, you know, I'll pop it right now. I did some recording last week, 2014, a banner year. You can find it at Wisconsin On Demand under the Varsity tab. And you can hear it across ESPN Wisconsin. I did an interview with a lot of different people from the 2014 Final Four team. Bo Ryan airs tonight at 7 p.m. on ESPN Milwaukee. No, it's 6 p.m. tonight. We got 6 p.m. tonight, ESPN Milwaukee. 7 p.m. on ESPN Madison. That is my interview with Bo. We'll have Jim Polzin of Madison.com with Ian Eagle, who's calling the Final Four this year. He had called the round of 32 game in the Bradley Center against Oregon.
How does he spell his name?
Like Ian.
Oh, okay.
Ian.
Is that a Scottish?
I don't know. I don't know what you're going to say, but I don't know how Ian Eagle chose to pronounce his name. Ian.
Up to interpretation.
There'll be a part one with Josh Gosser and Frank Kaminsky and myself on Wednesday, a part two with us on Thursday, and a bonus edition where if you like to listen to me, which God bless you, and thank you for listening to KBN, I have the long form version of what I had experienced in my perspective of the 2014 team, bridging into what was the 2015 year. So go to Wisconsin On Demand. I tweeted out a couple of things as well. And the reason why I mentioned that is because Sweet 16 Thursday, Friday, Elite 8 Saturday, Sunday. And then you get off the high of having great things to look forward to. And we're thrown just a wonderful, wonderful game at 6 p.m. Central tonight, LSU versus Iowa. And look, we've had some fun talking about Caitlin Clark and my basketball skills as an old 32-year-old, you know, this, that, and the other thing. But the reason why we're able to talk about Caitlin Clark is because she's the biggest star in college sports. Name someone, like, and I challenge, and I do want to know, because we put it up on Twitter at KBN ESPN, is Iowa versus LSU tonight the most exciting game in college basketball this season? And, like, for me, it's an easy yes. I very much look forward. I want to see Purdue-UConn match up. But in terms of, like, Caitlin Clark, who's bigger? Who's bigger? Who's bigger? Not Tyler Kolek.
From a national standpoint, I can't think of anyone that's bigger, has more name recognition, and has done more for her sport, her or his sport.
There is no bigger names in college basketball than, honestly, Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese. Those two individuals, what they did last year for the women's NCAA tournament, they brought excitement to the tournament. They brought personality to the tournament. That was well worth watching. If you go out in the market hall here in downtown Milwaukee, the 3rd Street Market Hall, and you ask 10 people to name the college basketball stars, or you ask them who Caitlin Clark was or Angel Reese, a lot of them will say yes. They transcended popular culture with their skills on the court and their personalities off the court.
So, yeah. And I'm shocked by this already. Early in the voting, 30 votes in, we just put it up 2 minutes ago. Is the Iowa-LSU game tonight the most exciting game in college basketball this season? 45% say yes. For those who say no, I honestly want to hear from you because I am a diehard college basketball fan. I am a nerd. I sit in January and auction with teams of the top 40 of KenPom, which is some nerdy basketball guy. And he's got all these statistics. We got Bart Torvik. We got all these things in a spreadsheet. And we auction on teams. And I follow college basketball. Like, but when you say Caitlin Clark, I know Caitlin Clark. And she's bigger than all the games that I've watched. Mm-hmm. Even though I know all these guys. Like, Zach Edey, cool. He's big. But he didn't transcend the men's basketball game.
Nope.
Yeah, I mean, if this isn't the most exciting and memorable game of all of college football or college basketball this year, I need to know what the game is, because to me, I thought of all the ingredients of what makes a game excellent, makes it exciting, makes it memorable, and something that I want to be like, I need to make sure I'm on my couch at 6 p.m. to watch this game. And here are the things I came up with. There are superstars, which there certainly are with Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese, entertainment, personalities.
Entertainment being the rematch of the national championship game that had 9.9 million people watching last year.
Greatness, and this was the most important part. I added one late when I thought about it. Rivalry. When is the last time we thought of rivalries when it came to basketball in the college realm? Because with the way their transfers are, one and done's, rarely do you have... Yes, there's the
If UNC Duke matched up in a national title game, I would say yes, but I don't even know if that's ever happened.
But those are program rivalries. Remember back in the 80s, 90s, even 2000s, where you'd have guys stay for 4 years, they would face each other over and over, year after year. Those became storylines and rivalries of themselves. This Angel Reese clip, Caitlin Clark, this is a rivalry. This is a very exciting game that you don't get that kind of bad blood and tension between any two players and any two programs like you do between these two teams tonight.
800-990-3776, Rip and Rona. I think Caitlin Clark is the most known college athlete, not just basketball player. And that's like to the overall point. And that's why I'm shocked that on Twitter, it is, again, as voting keeps going up, it's still around 50-50. Like, somebody tell me what is a bigger game than Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese, Iowa versus LSU?
There isn't anything bigger. And what I love about this, and Brad, you hit it perfectly, is that anytime you watch a book or you go to a movie, it's all about character development, right? And so when you have an opportunity to watch these players for 4 years develop and have those rivalries, have their arch nemesis, watch them go up against each other, then you want to see the next time they have an opportunity. And that is exactly what women's basketball is at this point. The rise of women's basketball is based on the fact that they do have those stars. They do have those personalities. They do have game as well, but then you have an opportunity to see a national championship game rematch with two superstar women's basketball players. Two superstar college basketball players again go at it for an opportunity just to go to the Final Four. I love this new era and age of basketball that we are in, and I call it the Steph Curry era of basketball. Why I say that is because a lot of these players are about scoring and putting on performances, and that is exactly what you get with college basketball in general. But when you look at the women's game, everybody wants to see Caitlin Clark because she does what?
She scores. I think it's just the fact that she is unbelievable at a specific version of her craft, right? And Chef Ed nails this, right? I think 800-990-3776. It's like watching golf because Tiger is playing. I watch women's basketball because of Caitlin Clark. And per my guy Ben Scott Stevens, Iowa has been featured in the three most watched NCAA tournament games for women in the last 20 years. 24 this year against West Virginia, 4.9 million. Last year in the Final Four against South Carolina, 5.6 million. 2023 against LSU, 9.92 million.
Incredible.
Well, and it goes to show that Caitlin Clark's star power, because she's a gravitational force for her sport and all of college sports. And when you think about what sports really is, like, why are we drawn into it? You say character development. It's the only real drama that's out there. Real life, unscripted, real time drama. Movies, TV shows, it's all scripted. Even reality shows, to be real. Those are all scripted.
Kyle and I are suckers for them.
This is like real before your eyes drama unfolding right in front of you. And even where Angel Reese had like the pointing at her ring finger last year, like it just adds a layer of rivalry.
The face.
Yeah.
It's just like you don't get that anywhere. And to get this in the women's sport, to have girls that are fun to watch, they're entertaining, rivalry, bad blood, and greatness all in one. This is gonna be one of the best games of all the year.
I'm not gonna lie. And look, I'm 6'1", 6'2", somewhere in between. I don't know. Shoes, no shoes. Obviously, I'm very proud of playing at a high level in Division I basketball for the Wisconsin Badgers. My girlfriend, 5'3", right? We're not breeding a Zach Edey. Let's just be honest here. And my daughter is not a male. So when it comes to that, right? Like, I've been playing in a basketball league, and I talk to all these dads that have kids who are growing up playing women's basketball. People travel all over the damn world just to see Caitlin Clark, Right? Like, I remember when I was growing up, I idolized Steph Curry. And he actually got to take me around Davidson's campus because they were my first offer. Bob McKillop, Steph Curry, Davidson. Like, I wanted to be that. And so now to know that, like, there's someone that I, you know, as a diehard men's college basketball fan, forget anything that I watched this weekend. I don't know what was so exciting this weekend that Caitlin Clark is not gonna top. Watching Marquette go 3 of 49 from three. Wasn't fun.
It's not even close.
UConn has won every game by double freaking digits.
They did go on a 30-0 run.
That was
obviously impressive, but in terms like that is over one game in which we know that they're so good, and we have a game now where there is all of that. There is the potential of drama, great basketball play.
Missing is this. Nobody, a normal person can't tell you one player on UConn's team. A normal person can only tell you Zach Edey on Purdue.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. I'm a true fan.
But no, I said a normal.
I'm not a normal person.
A casual fan would not.
Zach Edey's popularity doesn't come because he's talented. It comes because he's a giant, right? And he's been around for so long. And so when you look at these Final Four teams in the men's side, they don't have the same things that Brad was talking about. The stardom, the personality, and all the talent. They don't have that. The women's game has that. That's why I'm excited to watch the NCAA tournament for the women. Will South Carolina finish with an undefeated season? Can they do it again? They have a young sensational star at USC and Juju Watkins, who is the next big name coming up. Paige Beckers was a superstar in high school, and she was one of the best college players when she came on as a freshman. There are so many storylines in college and women's basketball that everybody should be excited to watch women's basketball, and tonight's game is going to be fun to watch.
And here's the thing. If you don't know anything about it, it's the perfect entry point in. Right? Like, if you're like, hey, I've never gotten a shot, I understand, I've seen the Caitlin Clark buzz. I'm telling you, as a diehard basketball fan, you will be entertained. Like, and that's the thing. It's all about entertainment. Entertainment drives people to watch something. Like, it drives you to listen, hopefully, to us, and it drives you to watch something no matter what it is. And if you want to see entertainment, and if you want to dip your toe in, tonight's the perfect night. 800-990-3776. Again, 800-990-ESPN. Brad, if I know you and we're watching the game, you're likely, even on a Monday, you're like, this is a big one. I need to calm down, just relax. You're going to do something.
I got a fridge full of carb lists that'll help me keep my stress levels low about this one, because I'm going to get all into it too. We're talking about drama. We're talking about excitement. And honestly, I'm just looking to kick back, relax. And honestly, this weekend, we had my parents over Friday night. We had a bunch of our family over on Sunday for Easter this weekend. You know what everyone was asking? Hey, can I get some of that carb list? Hey, where's that carb list? Everyone was having sips of carb list and saying the same thing. Oh, wow. This is delicious. Can I get another one? I feel great. And it tastes delicious. That's why Carbless is my go-to alcoholic beverage. I'm looking to kick back, relax, have a good time, whether it be over the weekend, a Monday night like tonight. That's because it's a premium cocktail with handcrafted vodka and tequilas that literally is guiltless. No carbs, no sugar, no gluten, 100 calories per can, less carbonation leading to less bloat. It makes me feel better. I'm trying to eat healthy, work out. I don't want to just detonate everything I do when I want to be able to relax a little bit. That's why Carbless is amazing and guiltless, but the flavors, guys, the flavors are unbelievable. It's starting to be summer, and there's going to be those fruit flavors that are really going to hit the spot, like raspberry, cranberry, pineapple, and those classic cocktails that are oh so good, like Paloma, Margarita, and Moscow Mule. That feels like it's being made right in front of you. If you haven't tried Carbless, honestly, what are you waiting for? Everyone around me is asking for it. Everyone's tried it. They've all said the same thing. This is better than advertised. It's time for you to figure out why Liss is more and find them online and at retailers near you. Carbless, baby.
Still trying to figure out why it is as close as it is. Is Iowa-LSU the most exciting game in college basketball this season? 50-50. How is it this close? How is it this close? No men's... And I've watched the opener where they play Kentucky, Michigan State, and those Blue Bloods in the early tip-off that nobody actually watches because it's in the middle of football season. We have the Thanksgiving tournaments. Sure, the Bahamas tournament's fun and the Maui tournament's fun. You have conference play. Sure, we all watch it locally as fans, but nothing has lived up to the way Caitlin Clark has made me go out of my way to watch her the way that Chef Ed said that when Tiger plays, he watches. Mm-hmm. When Caitlin plays, he watches. There's going to be drama tonight. And
what time?
6 o'clock.
Yeah, I can't wait.
There it is. Kyle Bruston-Nortman, we cheers to and pour one out. That's next.
This is Kyle Bruston-Nortman, KBN.
My offer, as we've come up with it at KBN, thanks to JD and Fondy, reutilizing Judy, who is still in my garage right now.
Is she a big booty Judy or a little flat flapjack booty Judy?
She's got a little something to her. I'll say that.
Yeah, she got some
Judy the flapjack. Judy the blow-up doll. She got a little something to her.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
We do have some backups starting things off on southbound 43 from just before Hampton Avenue down past Capitol Drive. Northbound side's heavy from north up to Keefe. Westbound 94 backing up right out of the Marquette all the way to Mitchell Boulevard. And some delays along southbound 894 starting at Oklahoma Avenue down and around the Hale. The westbound side is backed up through the construction zone, basically out of the Mitchell Interchange all the way to 68th Street. Traffic is brought to you by the 3rd Street Market Hall, your one-stop destination for basketball this March. Catch the entire tournament with the best local food and drink for the ultimate viewing experience. Only at 3rd Street Market Hall. And check the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight. Cloudy skies, scattered showers, a low of 36. Tomorrow, a chance for rain to snow, breezy, a high of 39. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 94.5 ESPN.
Hey, this is Gabe Nigel from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. Baseball season is here, and the Brewers' home opener is right around the corner. Guess what? 94.5 ESPN is going to be there. JGC broadcasting live from the warning track at AmFam Field on Tuesday from 7 to 9. Tune in on 94.5 ESPN, WisconsinOnDemand.com, and on ESPN Milwaukee's YouTube. You won't want to miss out. And I hear I might even be racing somebody on the warning track. It's Jen, Gabe, and Chewy live from the warning track at AmFam Field Tuesday from 7 to 9 right here on 94.5 ESPN.
We've told you about Moses Adara,
the diamond cutter who created the Kessler 81.
The magical diamond that vibrates with light.
Kessler's works with crazy diamond cutters.
Geniuses who create wonderful, spectacular,
crazy diamond shapes.
The one thing these crazy genius diamonds all have in common
is that they explode with light.
The Kessler Emerald Cut Diamond sends out rippling waves of light, like water lapping onto a beach.
The Kessler Square Radiant Diamond glows like the sun on the horizon.
Sometimes sunrise.
Sometimes sunset.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Ask to see the rippling waves of light, like water on the beach.
Ask to see the glow that looks like sunrise and sunset.
Ask to see the Kessler Crazy Genius Diamonds.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
To find the Kessler's nearest you, visit KesslersDiamonds.com.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here, and there is one thing I think everyone can agree on. Potholes stink. And this year's weather will make it one of the worst years yet. Well, Johnson & Sons Paving is ready to take on the challenge with a team that has over 2 decades of experience. When the potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole area. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get that appointment booked before May 31st, and you might even see Old T on the job site for a visit. Find full contest details at ESPNWisconsinContest.com.
Hey, it's Gabe Nigel from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. You've heard me talk about the results mentality has had on my life, but don't just take it from me. Jason has had success too, thanks to mentality.
My only regret is I didn't do it sooner. Knowing once again I've gotten the treatments done and continuing, I do feel, you know, stuff does hurt a little bit more, but I'm 40, you know, in my 40s, and that's going to happen. But again, the energy levels, it is above and beyond. Again, it's I'm back in that age where I'm like, this is amazing.
Get started today at OTUSA.com.
You're listening to Kyle Bruston-Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Kyle Bruston-Nortman. Brustin Norton across ESPN Wisconsin. Hope you're enjoying your Monday to the best of your abilities. We are, and you can get involved if you want to. 800-990-3776. That's the ESPN Wisconsin talk and text line. I wanted more Beyonce country, because it's not even country.
I'm talking to Chris here. We can play the Beyonce versus Miley versus Beyonce and Miley Cyrus song. We can play that song coming back. That is country.
All right.
It's country.
All right.
I'm telling you, it's a really
Last time you said we're going to hire a country.
That was trap country. It was trap country.
Yeah. What does trap mean?
Trap means trap means it has like a little bit of a hip hop vibe to it, but it's not like trap. R&B is where a R&B singer kind of flows and sings, like he sings and they rap at the same time, kind of trappy.
What does ratchet mean?
What is ratchet? Now Beyonce's not ratchet.
No, I know, but I've heard that being said. Like you ratchet.
You've never heard ratchet.
Like, be ratchet.
I don't know. I think we should leave this. You know, you should Google that one. Why don't you Google that one on the work computer?
I'm using context clues to try to figure out what ratchet means.
I've called Kyle ratchet a couple times.
Let's get ratchet. Ratchet just means a little wild, a little out there.
Yeah.
A little, Brad hurts some people. Not filthy, dirty, but like you have a lot of fun, a little reckless. Brad hurts.
Could be, like if in the context, it could be filthy.
Ratchet. I mean, it could be. But Brad, where did you hear some people saying ratchet or something?
Is this in the locker room?
It's primarily from you, Kyle. Oh. I hear you saying
this wasn't like you and Cam Newton in the showers together.
No, we got heart to heart conversations in the shower. We're not talking about anything ratchet.
Why are you having heart to hearts in the shower?
Where else are you gonna have it?
Here in the 414 hour, what I'll do is every song we play during the 414 hour will be ratchet music.
All right,
and that's distinctive from trap music.
Yeah, trap music. Yeah, trap music. There's a Trap Music Hall of Fame down in Atlanta.
I mean this genuinely. Have you ever met anyone more white than Brad?
Not on a day-to-day basis that I interact with. No, but I love Brad.
I didn't say you didn't love Brad. I said, have you met anyone more white than Brad?
You know,
and actually, it fits because he has to use SPF 50 too when he goes out in the sun.
For sure. I use SPF 50.
Literally and figuratively.
Yeah.
I
don't
our
have
whitest
too many
guy.
Friends in Lake Country. I'm a city boy, so I didn't have too many friends from Lake Country. Going to Whitewater or some.
All right, let's get cheers to him pouring out. What am I doing?
The weekend is over, so let's pop some bottles. It's time for Cheers 2 and Pour One Out on Kyle, Brust, and Nortman.
Cheers 2 and Pour One Out. We see something over the weekend that we like, we cheers to it. We see something we want to pour one out to, well, pour one out can be just about anything. Let's toss it over Brad for his first cheers.
Guys, I'm going to raise my glass full of Carb Bliss and just cheers to the Milwaukee Brewers, right? The Milwaukee Brewers started the season with a sweep. Get those brooms out. I know the whole season's not going to go that easy, but talk about getting me excited for baseball season, for Brewer season. Starting the season with a sweep, it's a scrappy, fun, tough team, exactly everything that Pat Murphy said they'd be. It's just making for a fun season. I don't know if this is going to be their most successful season. I don't know if they're going to win 96 games. I think I'm really going to enjoy watching this team play, though. I like the way they play. I like how they win. I like how they're for one another. Even if they lose, I think I'm going to be okay with it by how they play. We're going to be there tomorrow at the tailgate house, by the way, to help usher in Brewers opening home day. So cheers to the Milwaukee Brewers, just getting me right the season with a sweep.
I like that cheers too. Kind of stole it from me. That's okay, because you know what? We love the Milwaukee
Brewers. The same thing.
So we'll pour up twice for that one. But you know, also I'm
pour up
cheers
your cheers to twice for that one.
Pour up and cheers to.
What's pour up?
Pour up is like pour up a drink, like to cheers to. Pour up.
I've never heard that
either. Now I sound like the really white one.
That's okay. We'll get y'all right. I got time. But so we'll cheers to that one. But then also I'm going to do this one because. Though we talked about it to start the show, I want to cheers to the Marquette Golden Eagles because of the fact that that is a program going in the right
direction. Oh, wow!
So cheers to Shaka Smart for taking over a program that was losing, that could barely make the tournament, couldn't win a game in the tournament, took over that program because the president of the university and athletic director made a decision that mediocrity was no longer acceptable. So cheers to Shaka Smart for taking on a challenge and letting people know that a lot of times it is greener on the other side. And so cheers to Marquette for continuing to take a step in the right direction. Meanwhile, my Badgers haven't sniffed the Sweet 16 since I was in college.
Cheers to the Marquette Golden Eagles. Here's the complete list of Shaka Smart teams he's beaten in the tournament since the Final Four. A 15 seed, a 15 seed, a 10 seed, a 12 seed, and a 5 seed. Cheers to them.
Great job.
Wow.
Because the team I love can't even do that.
In the same vein, who knew there could be so much?
Cheers to Rhys Hoskins. If we don't mention, you mentioned the Brewers. You can't cheers to the Brewers without mentioning the fact that Rhys Hoskins really helped invigorate and just get the season off to a fun start. Winning is fun, but in a 162-game season, you want to capture audience and show, like, hey, this is going to be a fun team. Him, Wang, the second baseman of the Mets, McNeil, was just so perfect. And then the Mets tried throwing at Rhys Hoskins after he was 3-for-3 in the game. They threw behind him. Like, it was so poetic. Like, the Mets are the Mets, and the Brewers, despite Craig Counsell, despite Corbin Burns being gone, despite no Woody because he's injured, despite no Devin Williams because he's hurt, Abner Uribe getting a couple of saves there, Piamps got one yesterday. I mean, you name it. Christian Yelich played well. You got young, fast guys that are fun. Terang's a fun, going to be future shortstop.
I like it.
You know Garrett Mitchell, he's hurt. This is exactly what you want from a start, not just from a record standpoint, but from a I can't wait to see Whit Miley back on the mound sometime too. The old vet. The old Louisiana guy.
No Corbin, no problem.
No Corbin, no problem.
Nor Clownsell, no problem.
No Devin, no problem. You name it.
Nope. I like that cheers, too. But in the same vein, I'm going to pour one out to teams Kyle roots for. There is a trail of disappointment behind these teams, Kyle, that you root for. Maybe your fanhood is the kiss of death, and maybe the Warhawks should be a little bit concerned now that you're on their bandwagon. I don't want to say it, but I got to say it. You rooted for the Badgers, and they lost. You rooted for the Marquette Golden Eagles. Full on the bandwagon. They lost right away. I'm trying to find the consistencies, the similarities between all of these. And unfortunately, the one that's most glaringly obviously is, Kyle, your fanhood toward those teams. So pour one out to teams that Kyle Wallace roots for.
I take issue with this because everybody's team
all
can't
we
win
know
every
is,
year.
But all we know is you bring in flip-flopping and trying to find a winning team, and then they end up just losing.
You were all in for Wisconsin. They lost the minute you go to Marquette. They lose.
Yeah, and actually, we got a text from Luis from Potawatomi Casino Hotel.
Yeah, I could pour one out for him.
He said, I blame Kyle.
You should pour one out for all the Marquette fans out there.
I'll pour one out for Luis because you know what? Luis, I apologize. I think the energy, I thought I brought positive energy, but then
no,
all of
it's
sudden,
called fraudulent energy is what it was.
And then all of a sudden, they shot 4-for-31. I mean, I guess I wasn't shooting with them in the gym, so that's why they shot 4-for-31. So I'll pour one out to Marquette's performance and pour one out to Marquette fans that really feel like I was the reason why Marquette lost. I apologize, and I hope this doesn't mess up our friendship and my ability to get those delicious milkshakes. And I look forward to having a milkshake again next year. When Marquette makes it to the Elite Eight, Luis. So this is for you, buddy.
Yeah, my poor one out. I mean, it's to Marquette fans.
You got it.
Not to the team. Not to Tyre Kolek. Not to Shaka Smart. Not to Osu Gadara. Not to Cam Jones. But to the deep, dark group texts that Marquette fans were in. Thinking they were sweet, no pun intended. They had their Sweet 16 shirts. We were sitting doing a broadcast at the 3rd Street Market Hall. One of my buddies, been in Milwaukee for a long time, helping put together something with the Al McGuire stuff that's going on. If you heard that on Jeff Sherman's show earlier today on our sister station 620 WTMJ, I said, enjoy the game. The Brewers were playing. He goes, oh, and you mean tonight? And I was like, yeah, enjoy that one too. Oh, and he goes, oh, you mean Sunday too? All you yuppities with your pinkies up, looking too far ahead, didn't take care of NC State. Pour one out to you and your dumb fandom.
Hey, don't do that to us.
I mean, I didn't do anything to you. You guys brought it upon yourself.
No, all week saying so prestigious.
It
and
is.
Here we go.
It is.
Basketball just, school.
Hey, you know it happens. You lose sometimes, but you know. It is what it is, fellas. But let's not turn each other. Let's come together as Wisconsin fans.
Oh, now you want to come together.
And support Marquette and look for a brighter 2024-2025 season.
Well, how about this, Kyle? One team that you do root for that I believe is still in a position to go on a run here. I think they're pretty much locked in that 3 seed at the end of the season as the Knicks keep losing and they keep winning at the right time. That's Bucks.
Yeah. It is the Bucks, and you know what? You can get a weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tune in to Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Marcus and his son Chris, a 1995 UCLA hoops champ himself, talk about everything happening in the Bucks world and joined by some of the biggest names in basketball. Plus, they'll answer your questions too. Stay on the beat of the Bucks and find Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus. The Bucks app and wherever you get your podcast.
Jason Wilde of Wilde and Tausch joins us next.
You're listening to Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN.
And I'm sure he'll offer this opportunity again.
Absolutely
what are you going to sell? What are you going to say to Ben Bruston?
You don't get your hand on my goddamn face. No. It's a no. I can say it in different languages. No, no, no.
Niche or whatever it is.
I don't know.
Nine.
That's a firm way to say no.
Nine. Next time we say nine.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
We've got some delays along southbound 41, stretching from Appleton Avenue all the way down to about Burleigh. So be careful. Give yourself some extra time there. We've also got slowdowns on the bypass heading down from National Avenue down and around the Hale Interchange to Forest Home. Westbound 894 backing up out of the Mitchell Interchange all the way to about Forest Home. That's that construction delay. Westbound 94 slowing from the Marquette all the way to Holly Road. The eastbound side's about the same thing from Holly Road to about 27th Street. We've also got some backup southbound 43, really heavy from Silver Spring all the way down past Keith. Traffic is brought to you by Fisco Auto Body. Call Fisco Auto Body to help with all body repair needs. Fisco, Fisco, Fisco. And check out the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, cloudy skies, scattered showers, a low of 36. Tomorrow, chance of rain mixing over into snow, breezy with a high of 39. Weather is brought to you by Fifth Third Bank. Custom solutions built around your goals. Member FDIC. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lazaga on 94.5 ESPN.
This is ESPN Wisconsin's Brad Nortman, here to tell you about my favorite go-to drink. That's Carbliss. Carbliss is a ready-to-drink, handcrafted vodka and tequila cocktail. Even better, it's zero carbs, zero sugar, zero gluten, and just 100 calories. And listen to this, less carbonation. This leads to less bloat. I can indulge in something delicious without having that health guilt. Carbliss is crafted right here in Wisconsin. It has a flavor for everyone, from black raspberry to cranberry, pineapple and lemon, and my favorite, margarita. Find Carbliss online and at a retailer near you. Less is more.
Suit up for the $800,000 sports car series at Potawatomi Casino Hotel Milwaukee. April through May, score free play, cash, one of four new Toyota GR86s or a new Toyota Supra. Play with your club card to earn entries, five times the entries on drawing days, and when the Milwaukee Brewers play at home. Got what it takes, slugger? Only at Potawatomi. For more details, visit paysbig.com/sportscar. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
True Chicago-style pizza is thin, crispy, and cut into squares. And thanks to Connie's Frozen Pizza, you can enjoy a true slice of the city. You'll enjoy it so much you won't even mind where it comes from. Connie's Frozen Pizzas are made from the same cornmeal crust Connie's has been serving for over 60 years. They're perfectly cheesy, perfectly saucy, and they're exactly what you crave. Get to know the true Chicago style with Connie's Frozen Pizza. Born in Chicago, loved by cheeseheads. Available in a freezer aisle near you.
The 2024-25 Bucks season promises electrifying performances, unforgettable plays, and even more historic moments. Be part of it by securing your seats now at Bucks.com/full. Bucks season ticket members get the best pricing, premier ticket locations, and exclusive benefits. Secure your season membership and lock in your seats for what's sure to be an unforgettable 2024-25 season at Fiserv Forum. This era of Bucks basketball is something special. Get your tickets now at Bucks.com/full.
Hey, it's Kyle Wallace for Universal Windows Direct. Call Universal Windows Direct today at 414-410-2000. And for every two windows you buy, you get two free. Buy two, get two. Buy four, get four. Buy 20, get 20. There is no limit. Call 414-410-2000 to schedule your free in-home estimate today. Tell them I told you to call and get an additional $250 off your project. For the last windows you'll ever need, go to UniversalWindowsDirect.com. And like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
The moment you've been waiting for is here. Eagle Sports Range is officially open for action. It's Wisconsin's largest indoor range, offering unlimited range time and 40 lanes, which include 20 20-yard lanes and 20 50-yard lanes. And no reservations needed. Just show up and let the fun begin. With a staggering selection of 100 firearm rentals to use, every visit is a new adventure. Eagle Sports Range is also a go-to for education. Take advantage of their concealed carry classes and gun safety courses. Safety first, excitement second. Visit them out in Cudahy or online at EagleSportsRange.com. Eagle Sports Range, where education meets exhilaration.
This is Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
So tell me now, do you want it? Because these dancing feet don't cry to the rhythm they cry for you. And every Saturday night that you ain't keep my tears blue.
Joining us now on Kyle Bruston Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin is Jason Wilde of Wilde and Tosh, which you can hear 9 to noon across these very stations. Jason, welcome into Kyle Bruston Nortman. When's Old T coming back? Not that I haven't enjoyed Wilde and Tosh, but this seems like the most extended vacation I have ever seen in my life.
No, it just feels that way because you've had to listen to me most of the time. And 2 days worth of Jesse without me or Tosh. I think he's supposed to be back tomorrow, but he's definitely been gone longer. Like, he went to France like a year or two ago, and then he did like a bunch of state park or national parks. So this is nothing. This is amateur hour in terms of his ability to take time off. So we're good. Is it really been 10 years since that first Final Four team of the two that the Badgers went back to back? Is it really been 10 years? Is that true?
It is 10 years. Yeah. 10 years removed from college, getting old and, have a child now.
You haven't matured a bit. I'm so proud of you.
I've made a little progress. You don't have to give me a lot, but a little.
A little. Sure.
I'll take that. But actually, speaking of which, and being a father, as I've listened to you and Tosh over the years, you've obviously talked a little bit about how, the girls go to gymnastic camp and they do different things where they've been able to form relationships with female athletes. And I think it's been really fun knowing that Caitlin Clark, Angel Reese, and the game happens tonight. I don't know. I just like your perspective, because I think this is bigger than any men's game, and I'm a big college basketball fan. There's no better storyline than LSU and Iowa playing at 6 p.m. tonight.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great storyline. I would argue that NC State and what their men's team has done, and now their women's team also reaching the Final Four, is better. I mean, this is a great matchup. It's a great game. Sydney and I, after she gets done with gymnastics practice, are going to watch the game. But, it's a fantastic matchup. I'm a little disappointed, frankly, that they're in the same regional, and that they won't be meeting in the Final Four, right? After meeting in the championship game a year ago. So it's a great matchup. I will certainly be watching it. But the fact that NC State has both their men's and women's teams in the Final Four when neither one of them were expected to be there, and what I've seen from NC State and their men's team beating Marquette and then beating Duke and Christian Leitner Light yesterday, I think they're a fantastic story. And DJ Burns, who does not look like your prototypical big man, I just think he's been so much fun to watch. He seems like a effervescent personality, different than Kim Mulkey. He's been really fun to watch too. So I'm really eager to see the Final Four for the men, but I will definitely be watching tonight, and I'm eager to see how Caitlin Clark and LSU do battle. I said this morning on our show. I like LSU's players. I don't like LSU's coach. She seems like a bully. She seems like Bob Knight, and I didn't like Bob Knight either.
Jason, switching gears to the Green Bay Packers. Last week, Matt LaFleur said something the effect of, "We have a better plan than we did last year," in reference to the chaotic offseason and all the youth. I believe you wrote an article about something like this as well. My question is, what does Matt LaFleur mean by that? And then what should our expectations be as the season begins because he says that?
What do you mean you believe I wrote an article about it?
I was thinking the exact same thing.
I saw it And I was, as I asked the question, I was like, I'm 99% sure that was Jason.
Is there a paywall, Jason?
Oh, yeah.
Well, yeah, but you have to pay for quality product.
I know. I was just checking.
It's a premium product.
I'll just set you guys my password, I guess.
Thank you.
So wonderful.
I love sharing passwords, but I support the Wisconsin butts. State.
Come on, guys.
No, I got it. I got Jason. I love having a job.
I was going to say, did you need my Netflix password, too?
I will take that, yes.
Because I know Tony Cartagena used to do that, and I think they caught on to Tony. Look, I just thought it was really interesting. There were a bunch of things that Matt LaFleur talked about at the NFL meetings. The most interesting one, to me anyway, was finding out that they were switching out Aaron Jones and replacing him with Josh Jacobs after the fact, basically, and that he was blindsided by the switch. That one really I thought was interesting. But the other one was this idea of how they can approach the offseason. I mean, think about where we were a year ago. Rodgers had emerged from the darkness. He had learned, allegedly, that the Packers were shopping him. The conversations were focused on who has the leverage as they tried to figure out what the trade compensation would be. And Alan Lazard had already signed with the Jets. Randall Cobb was not coming back. They had a couple of rookies that had played extensively as rookies, although they both dealt with injury issues in Romeo Doubs and Christian Watson. But they really didn't know what their offense was going to look like. And, oh, by the way, they were moving toward a quarterback whose two most significant playing time opportunities had been a very poor performance, regardless of Matt LaFleur trying to take the blame for it, against Kansas City, and an outstanding 10-snap cameo at Philadelphia in the 2022 season. And so you had a new starter, a quarterback, and you didn't even know who the hell was going to be playing wide receiver or tight end for you. And now fast forward a year, and all those young wide receivers and the two tight ends have a ton of experience. You know that Jordan Love doesn't stink. He might have some growing pains still ahead of him. He might have some inconsistent moments, but you know he's a pretty good quarterback, and we'll see how great he turns out. So it just changes the entire offseason dynamic and what the coaches are able to do in terms of game planning. They now know what all these guys do better. They can structure their offseason program to build from a schematic standpoint their playbook off of what they already have in the playbook, and they've seen these guys master. They remember for the first half of the season, too, they were just trying to figure out what plays they could call that the guys would A, remember, and B, execute. And so they're just in such a different place, and that should breed all kinds of confidence and optimism for people like Kyle Wallace.
Jason, I like that, and I've got a question for you about optimism as well. But remember, everybody, we're speaking with Jason Wilde. You can hear Jason Wilde every weekday on Wilde and Taus, 9 a.m. to noon, right here on ESPN Wisconsin. Now, Jason, optimism is a good word to describe me as, but one thing I'm trying to ask you is this, though. Jake Bates, have you heard the name?
If I have, I've never heard his name delivered that way. So I'm going to have to say I'm not quite sure.
Well, Jake Bates is the kicker for the Michigan Panthers.
He knows who Jake Bates is.
Okay, so here it is, Jason. So basically, like, Anders Carlson, he was a failure, right? It's a failure. Like, we should just cut him and just sign Jake Bates. Like, what are we waiting for?
I enjoy minor league spring football as much as anyone. That said, I don't think Anders Carlson's ability to kick from very far away is our concern, right? It's his inconsistency as a intermediate kicker, right? Is that fair to say our criticism would be, you know, from about 33 yards where the extra point is kicked from to about 50 yards, maybe, is where we're like, yeah, he should be better there.
I haven't seen him hit 60 plus either.
Jake Bates. Look, here's my feeling about kickers in general, and I don't care if they have to do it with the Birmingham Stallions or the Michigan Panthers or a minor league team. There's a I think the Saints' new kicker is like coming over from Ireland or something like that, right? And isn't that the? I go to the specialist, the longtime NFL punter, to fact check me on that. But my point is that, you know, I still, and I've told you guys this before, I want my kickers to have already gone through the growing pains playing for someone else, whether that's in the UFL or in the Canadian League or for another NFL team, right? I thought things worked out pretty well with Daniel Whelan, their punter from Ireland, this past year, right? He'd kicked in the, I don't remember if it was the XFL or the USFL. He was in one of the two spring leagues last year. And he came in and he was pretty good. He faded a little bit down the stretch, but I thought he was pretty good. And so I'm when it comes to Anders Carlson, they've got two other kickers now that they have in for competition with him. Obviously, Greg Joseph has kicked in the league for multiple years.